Alright, what? It's been like, again, and if you've been following my channel for a while, you'll know that I say this a lot, but it's been like 3 weeks since I played this game, and I don't know what I'm doing. I think I'm supposed to be like chasing plot stuff out to the south end of Humala City over here. In retrospect, I probably could have come out to this route to the south earlier before the gym battle to do training and stuff like that, but I didn't think about that, and, well, it might have made the battle a little bit easier than it actually was. Do I really not have a rappel on? Where are my rappels? Alright, well, problem solved. Another trainer. A swimmer. I really hope you have something better than a Remoraid. Why did I think that would be a good idea again? Alright, I'm back, pretend I didn't ever do that. Next trainer! There are a bunch of swimmers on this route if I recall correctly. I used to think Skull Bash was such a good move for, I think it's a an exclusive move to Blastoise, a signature move of Blastoise, because it had like really strong base power. But then you have to realize that it's like a charge turn move, so it's really more like using 250 base power moves over two turns instead of 100 base power. And the setup turn And even in game, it can give your opponents like time to set up on you and stuff like that, which is not necessarily a good thing. Or maybe not. Maybe it actually is a good move. I've never actually used a Blastoise in game. Anyway, can you just thank you? Plus, I'm pretty sure Blastoise just has access to better moves, period, than Skull Bash. Anyway, let's see. What is this cave out here? Oh, this is, I think, where I'm going next, or something like that. But anyway, this is a doctor who I can fight and will heal my Pokémon. Alright, very nice. You're gonna heal a Pokemon. You did not have a chance to hear a Blissey, which I am rather sad about, but... never mind. I can't for the life of me remember what this trainer is. Oh! I never knew this! I've played Black and White 2 like, probably 5 or 6 times right now, and I never figured out that you could just walk past this tree to this fisherman right here. I was gonna say, like, I thought he was part of another route or something like that. Just use a fire attack on a Frillish. Anyway, yeah, I never knew that you could just walk past that tree to get to that one fisherman there. I always thought it was part of another route or something that you could just happen to see from this area. Apparently not. I don't even know what I'd gotten that item ball down there. Anyway, now that I've gone on and on about how, like, I've never, like, talked to that trainer before, I'm gonna watch my old, White 2 playthrough and just watch myself actually go and fight that battle without even realizing it or something. Anyway! Item? No item. Somewhere else. There's this one down here. Also, I do have to say, for all I've complained about, Poliwrath not really pulling his weight in this game, Poliwrath is quite a good switch-in for, like, ice and water types and stuff on the occasions that I have come across them. I do have Pokemon who can switch in on water and ice, but not necessarily both. Anyway. I was standing on a blue shard, alright. I don't think I have too many of those. I don't really expect to be able to make use of any of the move tutors in this game, because I don't think I'll be really picking up that many shards. And a lot of the good moves need like 8 or 10 or even like 12, I think maybe some even more than that shards. Plus some of the, a lot of the move tutors you don't actually get access to until post-game, in which case it will be kind of late. Now, Black and White 2 do have some pretty decent post-game, but yeah, why not? Probably not that much to warrant, like, going and hunting shards for just a YouTube playthrough. Oh, yeah, I guess if I want to open up a shortcut, I have to. Not my favorite fight in the game. Yes, I am sturdier, I suppose. I got a bunch of defense EVs off that. I can now take a shortcut to Undella Bay, and I'm going to go back to the Undella Pokemon Center and heal, because I did lose a couple Pokemon in there. Did I really not fight you? But I really will not fight you two. Alright, I could have sworn that I fought all those trainers in Undella Bay before, but maybe like these items that respawn every... I think it's every day, every other day, I'm pretty sure it's every day. I don't know if the trainers will refight you also. Cause like I said, I'm pretty sure I came through and fought all these trainers before. Anyway, let's see, moving on, past that one guy who had all those crazy Bulldor and Roggenrola. The Roggenrola were more annoying really than than the other ones, even though Boldore used explosion and killed me. Where am I going? I need to go this way, don't I? Alright, don't cross off there. This will let me go to the lower part of, this cave. Hello, Black Belt. That guy's named Black Belt Drago. Same as me. Alright, well, there's nothing down here, and there's an island in the middle, and I think, like right after this, there's going to be an exit on the east side of the wall, and that's where the plot will advance. That's a heart scale. I have a bunch of those, don't I? I don't think I've actually used any for anything. I wonder if I will be, if I will have the ability to, like, reteach Dragonite Extreme Speed. In this ROM hack, let's see, yeah, there's plot over here. Hello. Alright, well, okay, so I guess I can't go there now. And I'm just wasting time down here, or something like that. I don't remember exactly where I get access to the coal rust machine to move that around. Anyway, strength puzzles. This is one of the more fun strength puzzles in the game, I might say. These 2x2 strengths. Boulders. I feel like they make the puzzles a little bit easier, and I'm not exactly sure why. Anyway. There's another trainer up here. I don't know what she's doing down here. So I got outsped by an Onyx a minute ago, and I outsped a Mian Shao. Seems a little backwards, IMO. Anyway, I need to push this rock that way. Let me push it into there. And okay, that's one, two, and three. Actually, that's more like three, four, and five, but who's counting? That's a rare candy, as if I didn't hack plenty of those into my game, as I say every time I pick up a rare candy. You're a black belt. Please be a little more intimidating than that battle girl. Probably think about putting someone else in leadoff soonish, but I'll worry about that later. This will put me back at the beginning, and that's TMO6 Toxic. Okay, that is a nice stalling type move, maybe not so much useful in-game. Especially not in a game like this, where you have to worry about like everything and everyone trying to KO you in one hit. Anyway,